Bonjour tout le monde. Good morning. Ullakut. Je suis très heureux d'être ici avec les ministres Vandal et Gould, but it's also good to see Premier Ahiagook and Minister Grass as well. All Canadians deserve high-quality, affordable childcare. With the rising cost of living, we need to continue to be there to support families from coast to coast to coast. That's exactly what we're doing. We have good news to announce today that we've reached an agreement with Nunavut that will cut average childcare fees in half by the end of this year and meet the $10 a day target by March 2024, that is 2 years ahead of the federal schedule. The savings on childcare for families in Iqaluit is estimated at around $14,000 a year. And the government of Nunavut will create 238 new spaces by 2026. Nunavut has been working constructively with us from the very beginning, and I want to thank Premier Ahiagook for his collaboration and his leadership. I know there are specific and direct challenges in the north, and that's where we've been so pleased to be able to work together to reach this landmark agreement. But I also want to thank the educators for everything they do as well in the north. Matna koana kuyanamik pe rivivut. Thank you to all of our daycares. We'll continue working with representative Inuit organizations to ensure that children have access to Inuit-specific Indigenous childcare through Indigenous early learning and childcare as well. On est là pour les familles et pour la classe moyenne. Aucune mère, aucun parent ne devrait avoir à choisir entre leur famille et leur carrière. C'est pour ça que ces ententes vont aider les parents à la grandeur du pays. This is the 12th agreement signed with provinces and territories right across the country. We are closer than ever before to a national early learning and child care program. The reduction of fees have been announced and are already impacting on families in places like Nova Scotia, Alberta, Prince Edward Island, and Saskatchewan. And I think back to the families and the educators I've met across the country as we've worked on these deals, on these agreements to support people. This is a game changer for so many families to see the child care fees cut in half by the end of this year, to know that $10 a day child care, affordable, high quality, more spaces, supported educators are only a few years away and getting to work on now. These are things that are going to make a massive difference at a time when we know Canadians are facing rising costs for so many things. Dropping the prices of childcare in places where childcare fees have always been far too high is going to make a huge difference in the lives of kids who will access high-quality education to be able to start grade one in the best possible way. Families, not just supporting in terms of affordability, but also being able to make those choices about resuming careers or engaging in the career that you've always wanted. And for our economy as well, making sure there are more women joining the workplace, more choices, better opportunities for people to re-engage. These are things that are going to help grow our economy at a time where we are looking for people to fill good jobs across the country. So I'm excited about this announcement and look forward to the impact it's going to make in real families right across the country. Today we're beginning a three-day cabinet retreat. Obviously we'll be talking about COVID, about the economy, about housing, about growing the middle class, about climate change, and about global issues important to Canadians and important to the world. But we will continue throughout being focused on delivering real, positive change for Canadians because, like we've shown with childcare, governments that work together and step up can make a real impact in Canadians' health, well-being, and economic future.